the slabs itself to decompose all those loads that are coming from walls to the beams. We decompose it to the beams, then it goes down to the columns. So before we can do that, if we want to accomplish that, what we need to do is we need to go back to loading. So we decompose by FE. That's it. So now you can see, if you go here now, you see that it's giving us, so actually means we need this as uniformity factor. We need this. So what we want to do is we want to decompose it. So it's giving us a batch of changes that will perform depending on the size of the number of flows and how the process will take continuing driver or use the option. So what we want to send to all beams. So we want to send to all beams. So I will close the access question, apply to all beams in the model. Yes. So now we have all our beams decomposed. So now we can go ahead to draw our strips. Let's draw strips. When you're drawing strips, what happens is that you need to draw your strips from on the x axis, you draw from left to right, and the y axis you draw from down to up. The end conditions are very, very important when you're installing your strips, and this signifies the end condition. We're working on analytical strips now. We all have FE strips, manual strips also, which are actually used for drawing strips on things that are on part of the structure where the engineer takes liberty of design. And so every strip is for delicate other more complex parts of the slabs where analysis cannot really be done analytically using the yield line method. So now let's go into this quickly. So you have this stands for the slab, this stands for the beam, this stands for the cantilever, this and the same thing for that. So now when you are drawing from slab to slab, you click this and click this. From slab to beam, click this and click this. From slab to cantilever, click this and this. Ditto for every other thing. So what we are drawing here is that we are drawing a strip from beam to beam. We call it bob to bob. So now what we need to do here to do is to click from bob to bob. Sometimes when you are not right with your end conditions, it won't draw. So it won't draw your strips if you are not right with your end conditions. Sometimes it won't draw your strips. So now we have this from bob to bob. So, and always remember that your strips are drawn in the x-axis from the left to the right, and on the y-axis from the bottom to top. So let's go to y-axis now. Now our hand conditions have changed. We have here cantilever, we have cantilever here. We have here beam, we have here beam. We have here cantilever, we have cantilever. So what we're going to do is that since we have this beam to beam here, what we'll do is that from here to here is going to be the same thing here. But let's start from here. So we have cantilever, cantilever. So we're going to take this and take this. Press down our contract, make sure that what we are drawing is straight. So now we have from beam to beam here now, we draw this. So now we have all our strips drawn.